And it's only about 3 seconds since I ended the last video. Hello everyone and welcome back for more of The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker. And in the last video, we ventured through the second half of the dungeon and we're at the end already. We got the dungeon item, we got the boss key, big key technically. We got everything we need. The only thing left that we need to do here in this dungeon is that, if you really want to. I mean, if you don't really care about getting 100%, you can go on. But I do. We're going to go get the other treasure chart that is in here. It's right over here, so hold on for a second to shoot these guys.
What?
I did the action command right. That is messed up, man. Get that. Get that. I'm just going to beat this guy because I want to. Ha! Defeat you! No! For you! Okay, whatever. Got all that stuff. Let's venture over here. And, oh wait, we're gonna need a, I forgot, we're gonna need to get that guy again. Come on out, man. Where are you? There's an enemy in here. There we go! Alright, let's defeat him really quickly. Alright, get his item. I don't really care about what he has. Oh, yeah, I do! It's another joy pendant! Jeez! How many of these do we get in this freaking game? Alright, good. I didn't think that would make it. So there we go. We can burn that away. You know you're gonna have to leave the room and come back, which sucks. Over here. Open this up, and... Which one is this? What do we get? This is treasure chart number 11. There we go. Alright. So now that we've gotten that, and my eraser just fell off my desk. Damn it. I know it is. Found it. I caught it with my knee. I don't know how I did that, but whatever. I'll take it. We're gonna go ahead and head back to the boss room. Because that's the only thing left we need to do. Sorry. So, how are you guys doing? I'm really sorry that Wind Waker is coming on really slowly. It's mainly just because, well, it doesn't seem like I'm getting really a lot of, like, you know, a lot of people really watching this Let's Play as well as others. But I understand because it's summer and stuff, which is cool. I mean, I'm kind of making this really casual. Plus, I have sort of an idea because I'm going away in college, like in August. But I have this idea where I think, because I don't want to, like, just hastily do this throughout the summer and, like, you know... waste my whole summer on Let's Playing. It's not, well, not wasting, but I think it'd be a cool idea if I did it pretty slowly, because that way, when I start college, you guys will still have videos. And by the time that, you know, I finish Wind Waker, if I do, you know, at the rate I'm doing it, that I'm thinking of doing it, I will be able to, Wind Waker will probably be done by the time I can get back and make more Let's Plays. So, that's what I'm thinking of doing. Also, another good thing is the fact that for my sophomore year in college, I already have a roommate, and she already knows how to do Let's Plays, and she's 100% okay with it. And there we get a Knight's Crest! New item! You will need, I think, about 10 of these, 10 to 20, I don't remember exactly, because I think there's jewelry ones to get either, but you'll need to get a lot of those and another freaking joy pendant. You'll need a lot of those because there's a piece of heart that will be needed in order to get that. Now, in these top pots right here are fairies. So let's get one in our bottle. And we get a bear, and we get a fairy in a bottle. Fairies, of course, if you don't know, they can refill your life energy. And if you die, it counts as kind of like a life shroom akin to Paper Mario. So there is the boss door. I have to quickly go and save and take care of something. When I come back, we will take on the boss. Of course, this will only be like a second to you guys, so I will see you guys in just a second when we go and take on the boss of Dragonese Cavern. Wait! I forgot one thing! There's one thing that I forgot to do, and I can't believe I totally skipped out on doing this, but after leaving, I realized, wait a minute, there's one thing I never did here back in, Dragonese Cavern. Hey, Pashley? We need to talk to Kaboli over here. Who runs the mailing center? Well, no, I've not seen your young face before, hmm? You wouldn't be here in response to our posting for some part-time help, would you? Sure. Oh, excellent. That is good. But first, I need to see... to see if I can use you or not, I need to give you a little challenge. Mash a seal in the envelope, put the same icon on the shelf, and throw the letter onto that shelf. Real easy. Simple. Use blah, blah, blah. Like I said, simple. Is that clear? Sure. When time runs out, you have to sort at least 10 letters. Do your best shot. All right, 10 letters is super easy. Now, when it comes to minigames in, like, Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask, I absolutely hate them. But the minigames in Wind Waker, I legitimately like. I think a lot of them are really fun. This one is really fun, and it's really easy for me, too. So, you see, getting 10 is not at all hard at all. Honestly, if you cannot get 10 in this, then that's kind of sad. Ooh, geez, I got a lot of them right there. I'm gonna get first try. Oh, 22. Okay, that's pretty good. 22 letters. Great, good, terrific, amazing. You pass. You get one ruby for every 2 letters. Oh, well, yeah, that kind of sucks. So, at first, he'll give you 1 ruby for every 2 letters you deliver, which is pretty nice. But if we talk to him again, we can do it for 20 or more letters. I believe after this, he'll give you 1 rupee per letter. So, if you're really struggling with money this early in the game, I have no idea why you would. But, you can do this, play this little game, and this will definitely help you get a lot of rupees. Right. Come on. I'm getting a lot over here. I mean, it's making it really easy for me to do. Right. I pretty much memorized where all the icons are, so, I mean, this has become super easy for me. I don't know what the icons are for, but whatever. Ooh. Oh my god, can I get... Dang! I got 25! 25 is the one that you're gonna need for the next one, so... That's pretty good if I can get that. Come on, anytime. I mean it. Anytime. The better you do, the higher your salary will become. That's economics. Yay. I studied economy, and I did really well in class. Alright, so let's do the 25 one. You have to do 25 or more. 3. Come on. Oh, yeah! Ooh, 26! 26 letters! You have amazing coordination. Seriously, I'm stupefied. Incredulous. We've had reviews all day long, and even we have a hard time getting that to map. I gotta give you some more money. Got to. 3 rupees per letter comes to 78 rupees. How's that sound? That's pretty good for this early game. Hey, anyone happy to be Blake, would it? It is, isn't it? Mm-hmm. I thought you looked like the lad the chieftain was talking about. In that case, I should have expected you to be able to pull off something like this. I've heard all about you. Yes, I sure have. You have a rough time, Blake. I feel bad for making you help us. It's okay. This is fun. Hey, things are looking up. Our new helper just arrived. Maybe you can give him some advice the next time you come by. So that's something you want to do. Now, of course, you want to come back and talk to the attendant later on. But for the meantime, I'm going to talk to this guy because he has an awesome mohawk. And I'll meet you guys back in Driver News Cavern. Okay, now after deviating, because I forgot to do a challenge, let's go and face the boss of Dragon Roost Cavern. Now I like to call this the Star Fox boss of the Zelda series, and you'll see why in just a second. If you do not know, guys, this is Goma, the first boss of the game. Now, why do I call this the Star Fox boss? Because of this simple reason. You guys know Andross, right? How many times have you freaking fought Andross in the Star Fox series? So many times. You fight Goma so many times in the Zelda games. But anyways, the goal of this is to hookshot onto Valu's tail. Swing across. If you land one of those platforms up above, that would be really good. This is going to drop down. It's going to hurt Goma. Of course, Goma is a she. A lot of people forget that. So yeah, you fight Goma so many freaking times in the Zelda series. It's crazy. Oh, come on! That wasn't cool. Dude, what are you doing? All right. This. Get away from me, you creepy insect. Oh, that was nice. Swing over.
What the heck?
Okay, this boss is being cheap. No, 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 no. Hi, I'm gonna need some. And let's stop being dumb and let's not get hit on this one. Alright, there we go. We'll shot onto it. Now, what really sucks is that during these, like, scripted scenes, you can get hit. And it really sucks when that happens. Come on, I landed up on top. Of course, it doesn't matter because you only have to do this 3 times. And then that breaks away the protective coating. And now, Goma looks even creepier. Alright, now when Goma comes close like that, you want to hit her with your hookshot in the eye and do some damage to its eye. I can't speak. Hookshot its eye so that way you can get close and attack it. There we go. Why don't you get one hit? Sucks. Come on. Come on. Oh, that was close. Holy crap. Alright, come on. Get out. There we go, and this should be it! Yeah! Now we won't have to fight Goma ever again. Until Twilight Princess. Well, he said that. And that looks painful. You're in lava, I mean, come on. And that's how you get ahead of Goma. And that right there, if the pot would get out of the way, is our reward for beating any Zelda boss. And we get a little Majora's Mask music whenever we defeat a boss, which is kind of cool. I don't know why I had to collect that heart, but anyways, this is our heart container! Which extends our life by 1. So now we get an extra heart container up in the corner. So now we have 4 hearts. Very, very, very nice. So now that we've done that, let's enter the little whirlwind and get out of here. Oh, and this is the song from Majora's Mask right before, you know, the final 6 hours play. That means something. Okay. Well, now the storm is gone, which is good, and Blue has stopped raging, which is very, very nice. Blake! Well, Prince Kamali, don't you have something you want to say? Yeah, you little bastard. I heard everything from Medley. Blake? Thank you so much. I'm sorry I mistrusted you. Yeah, you should, you little dipshit. I hope I can be like you someday, Blake. You will, Kamali. I just know it. Right, Blake? I'll say yes because I want to be nice to Medley. So, Blake, here. I want you to take this, Blake. Giving you the thing I value most will give me the courage I need to stand up to bad things. What did we get? We get Din's Pearl. This is the gem the Rito's clan was passed down from the Great Goddess. Now we have one of the great goddess pearls. The great Blue is grateful to you too, Blue.
Oh, hero, thank you. Use the wind god's wind.
Use the wind god's wind? What the fuck does that mean? Alright, that's what he said, but I don't understand. I wonder what it means. The wind god's wind. I wonder if he's talking about if that has anything to do with the wind shrine that's through the tunnel. Well, geez, no! I don't think it does! Almost forgot. The Great Blue also names you, Blake, a true hero. Yay! Arbiter hero, Cornju Dragon! I agree with him. As far as we're concerned, Blake, you really are a hero. No. Well, I'm gonna go and visit Valu. I'll come and see you sometime with the best pair of wings ever. Hey, Prince Kamali! Thanks so much, Blake. See you again someday. And we will. We will see. This isn't the last we've seen of Medley. In fact, I don't want to spoil too much, but Medley is very useful to the storyline. So yeah, she does play an importance. So, let's go venture over to where the Wind Shrine is before we leave. Oh, wait, no. Before I do that, I totally forgot. I have one thing I have to do first. Now, since we have defeated Dragon Roost Cavern, if you did the mailing sorting before defeating the boss, you can go back to the top of Dragon Roost. Not the top, but you can go back to the mailing sorting with Kaboli, and his replacement is there. I totally forgot his name because he's not Rito, so I don't bother to know his name. But he wants you to do the 25 letter sorting again, so you're gonna have to do that again. And trust me, you wanna do this. Plus me, yeah! I wanna be positive. So yeah, you can do, I believe you can do this really at any time and just leave and come back in and he'll be there. But I just wanted to do it before going to defeat the boss. And hello, Pashley. Yep, there's the guy. Hey man, I'm the new part-timer. Reading clothes and green hat? Pardon me for asking, but you're Blake, aren't you? Yep. Aha! I knew it! You're a legend among these part-timers here. I really admire you, man. Just once, I love to see the legendary 25 letter sort. Do your best, man. Damn! Come on. No! Okay, I'm gonna get it this time. Come on. Yeah! In your face! Oh my gosh! 25 letters. Amazing, man. I'm so impressed. Seriously, man. God damn. I had to show that. But every single time I tried to do it, I kept getting like one or two off. I can't. I just kept getting 24, and that's such a piss off in my face. So now he gives us the letter to Mom. It's so sad you can almost cry. So sad. So I could just throw in here with all the other letters, but I just can't bring myself to do it. It's against the rules, man. So we're gonna mail that letter to him for his mommy, which I don't really mind to do. Hello, Pashley. So that's what we're going to do. Blah, 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 blah. But damn, I can't believe it. Like, I'm really good at that game too, but let's play Curse, man, and just me not having nice things. I kept getting like one or two off, and that's such a kick in the teeth. Like, seriously, it's just like you're so close. That's because I kept missing sometimes. Or I'd stall. Because if you stall, it's over. Good morning. Welcome to the Island Postal Service. Do you have a delivery? Yes, I do. So hold on, let's get our stuff and get ready. No, don't! Okay, good. Oh, please tell me that I did. Okay, good. I thought for a second I delivered that fair. I'm like, oh god, please don't tell me. Okay, I'm just gonna say this right now. You will need that fair for something important. So make sure that you have a fair with you at least through the first half of the game. Because there's something that you will need for it that will be very helpful. This box is near Dragon Slime. Postage is only 5 rupees. Do you wish to send this now? Yes, I do. Alright, so there we go. At least I got to spend some freaking rupees. And now that we've done all that, let's go off to the Wind Shrine. And I have to do this really quickly because I have some plans with friends and they're waiting for me. I have some other stuff waiting too, so I'm doing this and I'm waiting for that and waiting for my friends. Let's go over here and we should probably get our marker out. Let's check this. There's going to be markings that indicate specific directions. As you can see, one of them is gone, which is very weird. So we're going to take out our Wind Waker. Take out our Wind Waker. I press the wrong button. It's gonna teach us a song. La la la. What do we get? We got the Wind's Requiem, our first song. And what does this do? It changes the direction of the wind. A very awesome song. Yep, that's a mighty nice breeze. Oh! The name's Zephos. I'm God of Winds. Get it? Like Zephyrus? The god of the eastern wind in Greek mythology? So you're the new Wind Waker, are you? Great. For a beginner, you got a nice wind sense about you. I like you, kid. I like this guy already. He's a frog on a cloud. And hold on, let me see. The tune you just picked up, well, it gives you control over the direction the wind blows. Depending on how it's used, the wind can be a good thing or a very bad thing. Want an example of it being a bad thing? Then you should see my brother. It saddens me to say that my brother, Cyclos, is miffed about his monument here being broken, and how he spends his time creating cyclones to torment people with. Maybe we can fix it. So if you encounter any cyclones at sea, chastise my brother for me, will you? Alright, and that is my request for you. That guy's weird. Okay, but anyways, on getting the Wind's Requiem and doing the 25 letter sorts, and defeating Dragon Roost Cavern and the boss and helping out Baloo and becoming a true hero, I think that just about does it for this video, guys, because we've done a lot. So sadly, in the next video, we will have to leave Dragon Roost Island. As sad as it is for me to say that, we'll have to leave this great island. Then drop to the next area. I will see you guys next time.